What's good? What's good? What's good, Panther Nation? It's your boy Mike Ricks, man. As you see, I am here representing Carolina Panthers. You already know what it is. Yo, part of the NFC South versus the NFL, man. I just want to give my little breakdown of the draft picks, man. The 2020 draft. Now, if y'all been following me along, man, I've been saying I want heavy, heavy, heavy defense. Defense, 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 and more defense. And what did Matt Rhule do? What did Marty Herney do? What did David Tepper and them do? And them knew. Man, they went straight heavy defense, y'all. I couldn't be more happy and more proud of what this organization did in this draft, man. So, hey, let's get right into it, man. Let's get right into it. So what I'm going to use the CBS grading scale I'm going to give you theirs, and I'm also going to talk about mine and what I think the grades are. So let's get right into it, man. Let's get right into it. So as you see right here, man, we have with the number 7th overall pick in the first round from the University of Auburn. Yeah, we got another first rounder from the University of Auburn, but that's another video, man. Check it out, my emotions and feeling about Cam being gone. But anyway, man, we got Derrick Brown, defensive line, defensive tackle, defensive line. He plays all over. We're talking about the unanimous first team All-American. You're talking about the SEC Defensive Player of the Year. You're talking about arguably a guy that compares to the likes of Fletcher Cox, those type of players, the nastiness of an Ndamukong Suh. Good kid, man. You're talking about military background, so the discipline is there, his father. I'm a military brat myself, so I understand how the discipline and the structure affects your daily life. And I think this was the great pick. It was the perfect pick. From my understanding, from what I'm hearing, they said if Derrick Brown wasn't there, they were going to trade back. But since he was there, there was no way whatsoever. He was the only one on their board that they were going to take at 7, and he was there. So kudos to them, man. They got the right guy. You know, a lot of y'all feeling some kind of way about not getting Isaiah Simmons. I thought we were getting Isaiah Simmons. In my mocks, I had Derrick Brown almost every single one of them, at least about 90-95% of my mocks. So to see that Matt Rhule didn't just go out and do what he did with recruiting and go get the best athlete, he actually went and got probably the most dominant player in this draft, especially at this position. Not saying in the draft, because you know Chase Young is going to be a beast, but you're talking about a guy that played against top NFL competition already. You know, it was a record. SEC getting players in left and right into this draft, and he did his thing against every last one of them. So as you see right here, they give this grade an A+. I would have to agree. I think this was a no-brainer. I get it. Simmons has a lot of upside where he's that positionless player where you can piece him all over the board, all over the place, all over the field. But this guy here, what he's going to do, man, is so far of what we need in this division facing these type of quarterbacks. Got to remember, you got an older Drew Brees, an older Matt Ryan, and now the new addition, an old Tom Brady. And they don't like pressure. So the best way to get to them is actually up the middle. So when you get a guy that can play with KK short and just dominate the inside. And remember, KK had his best years when he had Starla Tulele. And now he gets a guy that's that dominant, that's going to be right there beside him. This is extremely scary. This is a very dangerous, amazing pick. And I see nothing but him getting better because that's what his trajectory showed in college. So I expect the same thing out of him in the NFL. So I really, really like this pick. I think we hit it out of the park. Let's move on to number 2. I did not see this guy being here in the second round. I saw a little bit of film before. Shout out to my boy DJ, because DJ was spoke very highly of, you know, one of our co-stars. of Gross Matos from Penn State, and I just didn't watch a lot because I was like, he's gonna be gone, so we won't have the opportunity to get him in the second round. So I just didn't until we picked him, and then when I picked him, started watching game film along with the highlights. This hands down, I have to agree with him again. This was an A pick. This was a steal. Yeah, I thought we were already set with Stephen Weatherly. I'm not saying he still won't play, but now we're rotating. We have depth. And whenever you have depth in the NFL, that makes your team so much better, and you put yourself in a position to have success. Because if one man goes down, we know in this NFL, injuries happen all the time. So now that we have a guy with depth, now you can bring Brian Burns. Let's think about this, guys. Let's think about this D-line. And if we happen to do the 4-3 or the 3-5-3 or whatever they want to do, let's think about this if it's the 4-3. Brian Burns, K.K. Short, Derrick Brown, and Gross Matos. Man, you got to be. It's special, y'all. You're talking about a 6'5". I mean, it's all a 6'5", too. Talking about a guy that's long and lanky, got a good bend. He extends his arms out so he doesn't get caught up in here a lot. He extends, gets rid of him, make plays. He's long and reach out to make tackles. He can rush the passer, all kind of stuff, man. This right here was a steal. So I got to give it an A. Nothing less than an A because this was a steal because he wasn't supposed to be there. So I'm great value. Great value. Well, so let's move on to our third pick that we use the Kyle Allen pick. Thank you, Kyle Allen. Thank you, Robert Bear. We use the Kyle Allen pick to move up into the second round to get a guy that I've been high on since my co-host again, DJ. DJ picked him in the mock draft. Now, I'm going to give y'all a little background story on it, man. DJ, he communicated this, but I was like, man, nah, he's okay, this and that, because I was upset because I didn't buy him. You got to understand, I play defensive back and wide receiver. Those are my positions. That's what I play. He was a tight end, offensive lineman, DN, that type of jump, man. So that's what he deals with. So for him to find this gem and I didn't, I was a little bitter and I was a little petty with it. But still, man, still, all in all, when I check this kid out, you're talking about 6'3", fast, run like a 4.440, rangy, got great ball skills, can come down, play linebacker, play nickel, cover man extremely well. You're talking about a guy that really, really, really is like a Isaiah Simmons 2.0. So for everybody that was in their feelings, and I know you've heard it over and over and over again, man, because I know we've all been talking about it. This is your guy. So, man, who wasn't kidding? Marty Ernie knocked this one out of the park, man. I agree. I give it a solid A. Solid A. Because, one, it defines a position in need. We already have Trey Boston, who's that deeper free safety type of guy. Now this gives us a box safety, which we need. And a guy can also play nickel, can play some corner on big receivers. We can move them all around. It just depends on what we're going to do. So this was a heck of a move. Heck of a move, man. You're talking about a guy that bench pressed 20 times, 225 pounds. That's insane, man. Vertical jump, 41, when your boy Isaiah Simmons was a 39. Ran a 4.45. I mean, Simmons ran a 4.39. Shuttle run, they ran the same at 2.58. I mean, everything else is pretty much dead even. So he's like 2.0. So I love it. I love it. I really think we got a steal here again. Great move. Great move. Great freaking move, Carolina Panthers. Then we got this cat from South Carolina by the name of Troy Pride Jr. that went to University of Notre Dame. Now, I looked at him, but I actually was looking at him we were doing a mock draft for the South as a guy for the Atlanta Falcons because it just happened to fall that way to board. So, and I think we got him in the third round for them, maybe it was fourth, I don't know. But Tell me about a guy with elite speed, track guy. Love track guys, man. He's about 6 feet tall, athletic. He only allowed like 5 deep balls or passes over 25 yards out of like 130, 120-something attempts, which is pretty phenomenal if you ask me. A kid that's familiar, I mean, hometown of Carolinas, somebody that's going to work hard, I think has all the skill set to actually come in, and his upside is better than what we had in Bradbury. No, not. I love Bradbury. But this guy here, man, he has everything we need. And there were some other guys out there that I really liked also, so not mad at this pick. I watched him. He's just a cover guy, in my opinion, man. He's very disciplined. He can lock up man. He can do zone. He can bounce back and forth with different schemes, and that's what I liked about him, because Phil Snow is going to throw a lot of different things out there, and he can adjust to it. Is he a willing tackler? I didn't see much of that in the films that I watched. You know, he kind of closed in but didn't lower the shoulder or didn't try to wrap or didn't try to tackle, that kind of thing. But he was in the vicinity, so who knows, maybe he will be a tackler. But maybe that's not what we need him to do. Maybe we just need him to cover. So if that's the case, then I think we hit on this one. They gave it an A-. I'm going to give it a B+. I know I'm a little hard on corner. Like I said, I played in the secondary along with wide receivers, so I'm a little harder when it comes to grading. So let's move on to the 5th-round pick. And here we go. I'm thinking, well, let's double down on corner. Let's double down here, because I wanted 2 defensive linemen. I wanted 2 corners. I wanted the safety. I thought we might be able to get a linebacker, those type of things too. So I'm glad we went the direction we went, because then we get a guy, Kenny Robinson Jr. out of West Virginia in the XFL. But this cat here can play, man. He's a playmaker, a baller. A guy that can really come in and learn the system and play behind the Trey Boston. I think he can learn a lot. He likes to freelance, which Trey Boston did a lot of in his early part of his career. So now Trey Boston has, you know, tightened that up, which allowed him to get paid, be that kind of guy. So this is a guy that he can learn from, and we could potentially have our replacement for Trey Boston. He could start with the freelance, but he did perform in the XFL and actually had a really good, solid season. His story, I'm not going to go into it, but I do want to say this, man. He wrote a letter to all the execs, all the GMs, all the teams, and just kind of explained what happened. He didn't have to do that, but it took a lot of pride, and not just say pride, it took some humility and a lot of maturity. It was very mature the way he handled that. So it wasn't like he was possessing a marijuana, which, you know, marijuana is marijuana. It's about to be legal all over the United States, so they need to dead that, which they've done already. But it's not like he's a convicted felon or a criminal or anything like that, so it's not a big red flag for character issues. It's just, you know, schooling. He went to his friend's funeral and had some stuff he needed to get done, and it happened, man. So he took the smarter route, which was to not get suspended or not go through all of that, and just went into the XFL and played himself into the league. Great move. With this pick, I agree. I think this was a B+ pick. I think he's a freaking phenomenal talent when it comes to ball skills and being able to really track down the ball and make plays. So it's a guy in the future, I believe. Maybe year 2, 3, maybe even now. He can come in and be a starter, but I think, you know, he's going to be a backup and special teams guy for right now. Bravion Roy, let's move on to the next one. Baylor, D-line, D-tackle. You're talking about a huge guy. What is it, like 330 pounds? Just tough to move. Just plug in. Just plug him in. He's going to plug and just stop the hole. One thing about him is this is one of the guys that knows Phil Snow and Matt Rule very well in this system. So he can hit the ground running. The competition there, he can also be a leader. They know what they're getting in him. Thought it was a great value pick. They gave it a B+. I want to say about a B or B+ as well. Not just because of that rule, but I saw his name pop up quite a bit. And just watching him, he's just a very stout guy. And now you double down on it. This is what we needed, man. We needed defensive line, especially in the tackle help. So you give him a Derrick Brown and a Bravion Roy there to go with KK and Zach Kerr. Some guys we got, man. Now you're talking about a solid rotation. Reminds me of that Kyle Love thing that we had, huh? So this is a younger version and hungrier version. You already know he's going to play hard because that's what Matt Rule and Phil Snow requires. So I thought it was an excellent pick here, too, in the sixth round. Great value for the pick. So, hey, like I said, it got to be B+ with that pick. Now, the cornerback, Stanley Thomas Oliver III, but FIU. Didn't know a darn thing about him. Not one thing. But I did watch him. I was like, wow, okay, he has potential. I like that we went corner again because we needed some more corner depth. So he's very fast. He's rangy, long. He's pretty good ball skills. Don't mind coming to hit. I actually liked his pick at number 7, man. I would give this a B+ pick because, I mean, I want to see more of him. Not saying he's going to be an instant starter. We don't need him to be an instant starter. But, I mean, special teams guy, somebody that can potentially make the roster and develop. And so I think they hit on this pick. Like I said, I want to watch more film on him because I didn't have much out there. So I'm going to continue to do my research because I've never heard of him until now. But, like I said, this is a great pick. So I agree. I think it's a B- pick. So that's the draft, man. We went 7 defensive players. Now, when I did my mock draft, we had 8 picks. I picked 7 defensive players and 1 offensive player, and that was a guard. It was a combo center guard guy. I am completely fine, and I've been preaching this for the longest. Defense. So I'm so happy, so ecstatic that we got these defensive players, man. Matt Rule, shout out to you. Marty Herney, shout out to you. David Tepper, shout out to you. That's what we do, man. We needed this. We really, really needed this. Because offensively, think about this, y'all. Offensively, we have Teddy Bridgewater, and a lot of y'all are sleeping on Teddy. Teddy can ball. I promise you Teddy's going to have an amazing season, especially with these weapons. A lot of people want to say, oh, Teddy, he only had really had one good season when he went to the playoff, and he had the best running back in the NFL, and that was Adrian Peterson at the time. Well, what does he have now? The best running back in the NFL, arguably, in Christian McCaffrey. Come on, y'all. So, look, man, look. He giving him more weapons than he had in New Orleans. And DJ Moore, Curtis Samuel, who wasn't utilized that or has never been utilized like he's supposed to be utilized in the Carolina Panthers uniform. And you go get a Robbie Anderson. You get a Seth Roberts, who's always been a solid number 3, that type of guy. But now you got him 4th on your depth chart, so that's even better. You got a Keith Kirkman, and yeah, he may make the team because he knows the system, that type of guy. You got your special teams guy, Farrell Cooper, who probably was maybe a year too late, but he still has skill. I'm excited to see what he's going to do. And then you also have Ian Thomas, and you got a guy, Seth, and I followed this guy, Seth, for a little while, man. Devilone or something like that, man. He used to play with the Browns, man. He played for the Jags. I followed him. He actually has a lot of potential. I think he's going to do really well at that number 2 tight end spot. Yeah, man. Then the running backs, man. You got Christian McCaffrey, who, you know, that's enough said there. You got Mike Davis from South Carolina, who's a dumper, tough kid running. Reggie Bonifant, who I love last year. Everybody was talking about Elijah Holyfield. Nah, I was Reggie. Elijah needed to go. He had nothing on Reggie, and Reggie showed. So we also got Jordan Scarlett and the Cat Murphy that we picked up, man. So offensively in the line, I like our line. Y'all can say what y'all want. We got a left tackle finally in Russell Okung. We got Greg Little that can back him up. We got Dennis Daly that can back Greg Little and him up. So left tackle. And then we got Taylor Moten if we really need to. We can shift all of that over. So we got 4 guys on the roster that can potentially play left tackle for us if injuries become an issue. We also went and got, like I said, Dennis Daly and Greg Little, that's going to play either the guard position more than likely. Paredes and Tyler Larson's, like Larson's a lot. Paredes had a rough year, but I think he bounces back this year. We went and got, I knew I wasn't going to get him. My bad, y'all. John Smith, John Martin, John. Sorry, man. We got the offensive guard from Cincinnati. Yeah, but what people probably don't know is that he did play with Teddy Bridgewater, so they have some continuity there, man, and he did a heck of a job for Teddy. So it's a guy that I think is going to really perform well on this team. We also have Taylor Moten at the right tackle, man. So the offensive line, I think, we're solid, straight. It's going to be much better for one because Teddy's going to get that ball out of his hands faster. And the way that Joe Brady's system is bam, 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 shot, bam, 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 shot, bam, bam, shot, bam, bam. We all over the place, man. It's going to be hard. It's not just one person. C-Mac's not just going to be the only guy that's touching this ball. We're going to spread that thing around, man. Spread it around. So I'm excited about what we're doing. Hey man. So overall, I give this draft grade an A-, man. I think we hit it out the park. Best draft I've seen in years. In years. So I'm excited, man. And the Panther Nation, y'all should be excited too. Very excited. But it's your boy, Mike Ricks, man. Once again, I'm part of the NFC South versus the NFL. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, comment, all that good stuff, man. Tell your people about us. Come give us love, support, man. We're going to start doing more and more and more now that we're getting into the football season. The draft is done. So, yeah, DJ, TJ, and we do have a still hiring sign for the Falcons Fed. But once again, man, thank y'all for your patience. Thank y'all for the support, the love. Once again, Mike Ricks, and I'm out.